Today we're going to take a look at how to use SSD as a part of a team with multiple developers, how each developer gets their own personal stage, the concept of stages, the Git workflow, setting up environments, preview environments. To do all of this, let's start with getting a good overview first. We have this in our doc here, but essentially it walks through the setup that you have. We'll just go over it really quickly and step into the details in a second. But in a nutshell, every developer on your team runs SSD dev on their isolated personal stage, so it's separate from everybody else's. When they're done or when you're done, you commit your changes to a branch called dev. That is set up to be auto-deployed to a stage called dev. Again, the names are arbitrary here and can be changed. Your team tests those changes on dev. If they look good, the dev branch is merged into a branch called production. Production is auto deployed to a stage called production, and that is the one that you're giving out to your users and your customers. So in the setup, every developer has a separate stage for themselves. There is a dev stage that all of you use for testing, and then you have a separate production stage. You can add more to this, like preview stages, and we'll look at that in a second. But that, in a nutshell, is the workflow. I have a very simple app here. It's got a bucket and a Lambda function. The bucket is linked to the Lambda function, and I'm printing out the current stage and the bucket name in that Lambda function. I'm going to run SSD dev. I'm not passing in a stage here, so it's using my personal stage. And you can see it's printing out the current stage that it's running on and the bucket that it's linked to. A stage is just a way for SSD to namespace your resources. So it uses the stage name and it uses the app name to make sure that these resources can be deployed across stages, across apps, into the same AWS account. And in my case, I ran SSD dev without passing in a stage, so it's using my personal stage. In this case, a personal stage is just the username from your local machine. SSD tries to use that. And so if you've got multiple developers on the same team working on the same app, they ideally should be getting their own personal stages. And the reason this matters is because if you end up with two developers or multiple developers using the same stage, they might end up in scenarios where they're overriding their work. Let's take a look at that really quickly. What I have here is the same app that we were looking at, but I've just copied it across two directories. So pretend there was an Alice and a Bob. We've got Alice here, and we've just added a new bucket. And instead of using the personal stage, I've done a deploy and I've done it to a stage called dev. So let's assume Alice and Bob are sharing the same stage. In this case, it's called dev. You'll see that with the deploy, the new bucket has been created. And let's say at the same time, we've got Bob. He adds a function. And you'll notice here, obviously, there's the bucket from Alice isn't here. And he also does a deploy to the same stage dev. What you'll notice here that's happening is, obviously, the first step, yes, the function's being created, but the second step, Alice's bucket got removed. Now, this will make sense to you if you watched our video about how SSD manages state, how it deploys these diffs. So, from SSD's perspective, for this scenario, there was no other bucket, and so the bucket just was sort of removed. And this is why we tell you, hey, you probably should not be using, the same stage across multiple developers, and why every developer should probably get their own personal stage. Now, a concern you might have is, well, if everybody's got their own personal stage, doesn't that get expensive really quickly? And if you're using serverless or pay-per-use kind of resources, this does not end up mattering because as you create multiple stages, if they're not in being invoked or if they're not in use, then you're not paying for them. So it ends up working out fine. However, there are cases or there are scenarios where you might be using expensive non-serverless resources and you might not want to create multiple copies of them. For that case, and we have this in our docs and I'll probably cover it in the future at some point, for that case, you can share these resources across multiple stages. So for example, let's say you've got an RDS database and you want that shared in your dev stages across all of your developers. You would deploy it in the dev stage, and then you would reference it in all these personal stages. And so when these personal stages get created, they're not recreating that same resource. Next, let's look at the Git workflow. So I've taken my app here, I've set it up with GitHub, it's got its own repo. I then go into the SSD console, I connect that repo to my app, and you can use GitHub Actions here. I'm using the SSD console to auto deploy it. You'd have to set up the workflow in GitHub Actions, but you can effectively get the same workflow if you'd want. I've got a couple of environments. I've got dev, I've got production, like we sort of talked about, and I've got this one for PRs as well, and we'll look at that in a second. So what that means is if I go in and I push and I make a change and I commit that to dev, it runs SSD deploy for me for that stage. And the same thing applies to production. If I make a change in the production branch and I push it, then it gets pushed out and auto deployed to the production stage as well. Next, let me go in and create a PR. So I'm going to do a very simple one here. I'm going to create the pull request. This is a pull request towards the dev branch. And if I give that a second and hop over to the SSD console, you'll notice that that PR was deployed to a stage called PR1. Again, just running SSD deploy to that stage. And if I go into that stage and look at the resource that it created, the Lambda function, you'll notice that the preview change that we created is also there. Finally, if I go in and merge the pull request, so this is sort of the end of the PR workflow in some ways. Once it's done, if I hop over to the stages, the PR stage is no more. If I go to the dev stage and I go to that endpoint, you'll see my changes have been merged into dev. Now I've got a setup here that might seem a little strict. I've got the branch name that's supposed to be the same as the stage name, and maybe it's a very specific Git workflow. Maybe you don't quite use it the same way, but all of this can be configured. For example, we've got the branch name stage name combo here. If I go into my SSD config, I can add this little block here. It's completely type safe. It applies to just the SSD console and the auto deploy feature in it. And what this is saying is, given that I've got a branch or a Git event from a branch called main, instead deploy that to a stage called dev. So you can kind of change what you want mapped to what. You can also change things like, hey, when a branch closes, also remove the stage attached to it. By default, it doesn't do that. You can configure the runner, or you can completely disable, let's say, auto deploying to prod. You know, there are a bunch of teams that prefer doing it that way, where they want a manual deploy. And in that scenario, you can go into the SSD console, and in the auto deploy tab, you can go in and you can deploy. You can pick the branch, the tag, or the commit that you want, and the stage that you want to deploy to. In this case, maybe it's production, and you can do a manual deploy. And that's it. That's how you set up SSD to work with your team, how you make sure that each of your developers gets their own environment, how you set up preview environments, how you configure your Git workflow or customize it if you need to. I'm going to be doing a lot more videos like this, so if you've got some ideas for topics that we should cover, leave a comment below, and we'll see you in the next one.